Last lesson of the quarter.
Angles and quadrilaterals and triangles. Let's define a few words. What the heck is a quadrilateral? It's got the word quad in it. What number does quad refer to? Quad. Four, huh? I'm gonna write that down. Quadrilateral, any four-sided figure. Check that out. Any four-sided figure, doesn't matter what it looks like. I'll write that down.
So now when I say any four-sided figure, I mean any four-sided figure. Any four-sided figure.
So in other words, here's another quadrilateral. Looks all weird. It's four-sided, it's still a quadrilateral. Here's another one. Okay, any four-sided figure is a quadrilateral. It can be a square, a rectangle, trapezoid, just this funky, skewed quadrilateral. Anything with four sides is a quadrilateral. Now, here's the next word. A theorem. I'm going to introduce you to two theorems right now. A theorem. I'll write that down. Any law of mathematics that has been proven. I'm going to introduce you to two theorems that are very straightforward, and that's how we're going to end the quarter. And I'm going to show you how to use these theorems, these laws of mathematics, and we're done. That's it. It's a very short lesson today. We've reached the end of the road of the quarter. This will be on Friday's final. We're done. I'm going to introduce you to two laws of mathematics to end the quarter. Next word. Let's get to the theorem, then. That red doesn't go with the purple.
That red is not going with that purple. The first theorem is the triangle sum theorem.
I'm going to write this down. The triangle sum theorem. So again, theorem just means a law. It's a fancy word for a law. The triangle sum theorem says this. The law about any triangle that ever comes your way.
The sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees.
Straightforward. That's it. That's the law. No matter how a triangle looks, you can take it to the bank that all the interior angles add up to be 180 degrees. That's the first theorem. Last theorem is coming right up and we're done. I'll show you how to use these and we're done.
How many angles are in the interior of a triangle?
How many angles do you see?
Three, huh? So all this theorem is saying is, look, angle one, angle two, and angle three.
This goes for any triangle that you'll ever come across for your entire life. All the angles, the measure of angle one plus the measure of angle two plus the measure of angle three equals 180 degrees. You're going to write that down. All the time, no matter what the triangle looks like, all the interior angles add up to 180. It's just this weird law of reality that's always true. Okay. Okay, so now that's the angle of a triangle. What about the angles of a quadrilateral? That's our last theorem now. I'll write this down. Quadrilateral sum theorem. Last theorem. Quadrilateral sum theorem. The sum of the interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. I need a quadrilateral. There we are. There's a quadrilateral. There we are. It's going to keep appearing and reappearing. It's kind of strange. I'll leave it that way. Make it interesting. So notice that quadrilateral. How many angles in a quadrilateral?
Four.
Four, huh? Okay. Angle one, angle two, angle three, and angle four. And no matter what the quadrilateral looks like, we can take it to the bank that the interior angles of a quadrilateral add up to be 360. So look at my equation now. The measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 plus the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle 4. I need more room. Equals 360.
All right. So write that down. So go to write example one on your notes.
Let's solve for x. I'm going to draw that quadrilateral, that quadrilateral four-sided figure. We're going to solve for x here. Let's solve for x. We have four angles. Two of the angles have x in it. What is the theorem that we just went over, the quadrilateral sum theorem, say?
Well, it says that all the angles add up to be 180,
and that'll be our equation. This angle plus this angle plus this angle plus this angle equals 180.
360, what am I saying? Coffee hasn't kicked in yet. 360. So let's do it. So the equation will be then 100 plus 84 plus 2x plus another 2x equals 360. Straightforward. That's it. All the angles add up to 360. So that's math one stuff here. It's a long equation. All we got to do, though, is combine like terms. Really the only funky thing going on. 100 plus 84 is 184. 2x and 2x is 4x. All right? Let's get x alone. We'll subtract 184 from both sides. Sounds good to me. 4x is going to equal to, I have no clue. Anybody got a calculator? I got one right here. 360 minus 184 is 176. Divide that puppy by 4. X is 44. Got it.
If we wanted to, we could just replace x into here to figure out the actual degrees of these two angles here. But the mission is just solve for x. But that's what you would do by asking for the angles, the exact degrees of these two angles. Okay? Straightforward. I'll throw a triangle, I'll throw a quadrilateral U on the final and ask you to solve for a missing angle. Well, you know all of them add up to be 360. Done. It's not that, nothing crazy about that anything. And last but not least, here's your last example. Example two. Solve for x. Throw in the triangle now. Go ahead and copy that down. Last example.
All the angles add to be 180 in the triangle theorem.
So, that's what we had in here. We got the first one, the triangle sum theorem. And if the sum means, by the way, added, right? The sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180. For the quadrilateral, the sum of the interior angles equals 360. Okay, so let's go back over here. Let's solve for x. We know all the angles inside add up to be 180. So this angle plus this angle plus this angle equals 180. Let's write the equation. X plus, what degrees is this? 90. There's that box, a universal symbol. Plus 2x minus 1, or 21, rather, 2x minus 21 equals 180 degrees. That's the math for one algebra. Let's get like terms together. We'll talk about this in texting. Let's see, 1x plus 2x is 3x. That's cool, man, all the way to the end. The last lesson. That's pretty impressive. I must say, I must tip my hat to that. 90 minus 21, I think, is 69, equals 180. Let's get x isolated. 3x equals, let me get a calculator, 121. Awesome. We'll divide by 3. X is...
40.3?
It's
111. 111. That should be divisible. I need a little fraction here. Same thing. So. X is 37.
All because of our triangle sum knowledge, we're able to solve this.
All right, so